Hello, fantastic fourth and fifth graders. Mark here. We're going to be doing some warm-ups today, doing some jumping, trying to do some balancing activities, and a couple things that you can do in your house or maybe outside. All right, so we're going to first start by kind of warming up by jumping in place, jumping rope a little bit to kind of get our heart rates going. And then we're going to move on to a couple other things that I want you to try your best at home if you can. All right, guys. All right, here we go. Let's get started. So first, we're going to try warming up by trying doing some jumping in place, kind of like you're jump roping. If you do have a jump rope at home or something you jump rope with, get it and try the best you can. We're going to try and jump rope at least for like maybe a minute or so, trying the best you can. Move this out of the way. If you can jump rope, you can jog in place and jump rope side to side. If you don't have a jump rope, just want you to try and jog in place. Just try and jump and jog at least for a minute. If you have a timer, do 1 minute. If not, you can try doing 30 seconds, taking a break, doing another 30 seconds, jumping in place. You guys got the idea. 1 minute if you can. Take a cool down break, a couple deep breaths in and out. After you finish that, either get markers. I have cone markers, but if you don't have those, you can find some kind of object in your house, whether it's shoes, paper towel, or something like that to mark on the ground to do some side-to-side hopping. So I'm trying to side to side, try and get 20 in if you can. I think 5, 6, 7, you try going a little faster. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Another deep breath in and out. Get the heart rate going, guys. All right. Let's try back and forth. Let's just do 10 so we don't have too much time on this one because I wanted to show you a couple other things. So forward and backward. Remember going back, forward, back, forward. You guys got the idea. Let's try also moving on to doing some forward, backward kind of sprints. So this time I'm going to use 4 markers. Find something around your house or something that you could use. I got some cones. We're going to kind of set a middle area. And our middle area is going to be right around here. Try to stay low. So we're going to do forward, backward pedal to your marker, back to the middle, side shuffle, back to the middle, side shuffle, forward, backward, back to the middle, side, side. You can bend a little bit farther from each other, side to side, forward, backward. So we're trying to shuffle our feet fast, forward, backward, side to side. Again, trying to get our heart rates up a lot, okay? Not sitting down all day in front of our computers. Although you're probably watching this and going afterward, I'm gonna try the best I can to do what I can, all right? All right, so after you got forward, backward, side to side, try and see if you can do 1 minute. If you can, awesome. Remember, if you need to take a break in between, do so. But then afterward, get back up and try a little bit more. Find someone around the house to help you with this or do it with them, even better. All right, guys. So after we're doing that, I want you to try and see if you can around your house, either get paper or something that you can make yourself like a ball. I made a ball out of a couple pieces of paper, some duct tape, and I kind of rolled it up. Just kind of being creative. You could use socks and bunch them up, or t-shirt, tape, something like that. Whatever you might desire. But remember, if you're inside, just watch out for where your surroundings are and be safe. If you're inside, but if you're outside, same thing. Just be safe, trying what you do what you can. So with the ball, we're gonna try and bubble it a couple times. All right, a few times, trying to get used to that. We're gonna try doing that while you're balancing. And then we're gonna try it in a small area. And then you guys are going to try a couple core strength activities that you could do to kind of help you get better at your crunches and sit-ups and stuff like that. So I'll show you the first thing we're going to try and do. All right, so take your ball if you have one. If not, get some. Try and balance it a few times. Get used to it. You can try and hit off your foot. All right, so you guys got the idea. All right, the next one you're going to try and do is you're going to go squatting down, push it up in the air, try and catch it. So going down low, squatting, push it up, try and catch it. Squatting, push down. I didn't jump that time, but try and jump. So see, I'm going down, jumping, pushing, okay? You guys got the idea? Going down low, squatting, jumping up, and catching it, all right? All right, so once you do that one, you're gonna try this one on your floor at home, okay? So I got myself a pad out here. All right, so take a look with your ball. You're gonna try and do a couple core strengths where you're gonna try and get your activity. You're laying down, down. You're trying to see if you can keep your legs in the air and your arms. You're just trying to catch it as many times as you can. You can throw it really high or you can throw it a little bit lower. But try and keep your legs in the air. Try and keep your abdominal stomach muscles nice and tight while you're doing it, all right? If you guys practice your sit-ups, up and down, this will be a good one to kind of keep your core strength going and your balancing. You can even try putting it on your feet, by your feet, down, bring it up, catch it. Bring it up, catch it. You can move faster. See, I got a couple of them. All right, if you have a ball or something at home you can do it with, awesome. Try and see if you get at least like 40 or 50. Take a break in between if you're feeling kind of tired, but I want you to try your best and do what you can. So say, I'll show you again. By my feet, bring it up, catch it. Try to go a little faster if you can. All right, you guys got the idea. All right, you can try a couple like this, or I could try coming up, catching it, coming up, catching it, coming up, catching it. Remember, we're working our core strength for our curl-ups and our sit-ups, guys. All right, I know some of these are kind of tricky, but you're going to try the best at home and see what you can do, all right? So I use, found an old painter's stick. If you don't have a stick or something like that, you could kind of get a piece of paper and some tape, same thing. Get creative around your house. Make something you can kind of balance with. You can do it on your head or something like that. So I'll show you. We'll try it on my head for a little bit. And I'm doing the same thing where I'm trying to keep whatever is on my head while I'm trying to curl myself up. Let's see what I can do. And then you guys are going to try it with me. Ready? So again, I'm having it on my head up here. Try to keep it up. That's one. That's kind of hard. It's kind of hard like that. You can kind of place it on your forehead. Maybe that's a little easier. And I'm going up and back down. Going up and back down. Going up and back down. If you can, try and touch your head. You're kind of balancing. Keep your mind on what you're trying to balance on your head and try to do your curl-ups. Same thing. You can try it on your feet. Try both feet. Try to balance up. Keep it on my feet. I can even see if I can reach up and get it. That's a lot harder. So I have it on my feet. I'm going down. My head's back. I'm trying to see if I can up and catch it. All right. Or try and just curl yourself up and get whatever object you have. All right. So try a couple of those as well. If you need to take a break, you can. But I really want you to try your best at getting your body moving. Get a little shorter breath when you can. Because you want to get those exercises in. Especially at these times where we're sitting in front of our laptops or computers a lot, okay, guys? All right, another thing we could try, take a look. So I have my stick out, try to balance one leg, keep my balance. As I'm keeping my balance, I'm switching hands. Kind of harder, a lot harder. So take a look, I'm balancing, catching, all right? So we could try and do this fast. Now this is one of those skater, as far as like ice skating or skater activity, so I'm trying to hold my balance, one foot hopping. Hold my balance, one foot hopping. Hold my balance, one foot hopping. So now I'm gonna try and do it with a stick. So I'm holding my balance on my left hand because it's my left foot. But as I hop over, I'm trying to balance and catch a lot harder. Balance and catch. Let's try three more. Come on, try them with me, guys. All right, ready? So I have my stick. I give you the hold it like this. One leg balance. As soon as I hop over, I'm catching, and I'm trying to keep my balance. Not as easy. Let's try again. Ready? Jump, catch, and balance. Jump, catch, and balance. All right, ready? And balance. So I'm jumping, catching, and balancing at the same time. Much harder, okay? Try and keep your balance going. Try and keep your core muscles going. You try a couple where you're kind of squatting down. Let's see if I can keep my balance So I had a couple like this. Really hard ones if you have super good balance. I'm not sure if I can do it. So you try and balance and keep your leg out and go down as low as you can. Much more difficult, but try a couple things like that. Try taking your stick as well between your feet. Go down low, jumping and catching. I caught my hat. Didn't catch my stick. Let's try that one again. Ready? Here we go. Between my feet, jumping, catching. See if you get 8, 9, 10 of those, guys. So be creative with whatever stick or ball you can make at home. And I am happy you guys are trying your best. I know these times are kind of tricky and difficult doing PE, but if you're at home and you have room, be safe. Do what you can to do these activities. And I can't wait to hear how well you guys do. And I can't wait to see you guys soon. Fourth and fifth graders, take care. I will talk to you very soon.